हुंडरूल इन डीजेनरेट ऑर्बिटल्स इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इंटर सिंगली विथ पैरेलल स्पिन बिफोर पेयरिंग पेयरिंग मीन्स कपूल पेयरिंग इन एनी वन ऑक्सीजन एटॉमिक नंबर 8 कॉन्फ़िगरेशन 1s2 2s2 2p4 3s ऑर्बिटल इज फुल 2s इज आल्सो फुल वी विल नॉट टेक दिस वी विल टेक इनकम्प्लीट ऑर्बिटल द कैपेसिटी ऑफ p ऑर्बिटल इज 6 बट हियर देयर आर 4 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन p ऑर्बिटल सो वी विल टेक इनकम्प्लीट ऑर्बिटल 2p p ऑर्बिटल्स आर ऑफ द 3 टाइप्स px py pz p ऑर्बिटल इज इनकम्प्लीट एंड ऑफ 3 टाइप्स px py pz px py pz px py pz px py pz According to Hund's rule, these 4 electrons will enter in these 3 block, 3 p orbital. Electron will enter singly, that is one by one, in same direction. The 3 electrons are set up in 3 block. And fourth electron will pair in any one, either in this, either in this, either in this. किसी the pairing is always in opposite direction. So we will indicate it by opposite arrow. If anybody show these 4 electrons like this. This is wrong concept. This is wrong. If any student show it like this, 2 electron in this, 2 electron in this, and this is vacant, it is also wrong. If any student distribute these 4 electrons like this, this is also wrong. If distribution is like this, it is also wrong. In all possible part of the orbitals. So here p orbital is taken under consideration. P orbitals are of the three types. The four electrons are present in the 2p. So we will distribute four electrons in three types of p orbital. Initially, single electron will enter, and each electron will enter in same direction. So this is first electron upward, this is second electron upward, in this third electron upward. After appearing of one electron in each, pairing will occur. So now pairing will take place in this. The pairing is always in opposite direction. So this arrow is indicated in opposite direction. So this is correct. And next example for under root, iron. Next example, iron, atomic number 26, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d6, 4s2. Here d orbital is incomplete, so it will be taken under consideration for the Hunder rule. Complete orbital is not taken. D orbitals are of the 5 types. D orbitals are of 5 types. So we will make 5 blocks. DXY, DYZ, DZX, DX square minus Y square, DZ Now we will distribute these 6 electrons in 5d block. First, second in same direction, third in same direction, fourth in same direction, fifth in same direction. The electron will enter one by one, and when one electron present in each block, then pairing will start. The 5 electrons are distributed up to now. We have 6 electrons. Out of 6, 5 electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 electrons have been distributed. Remaining 1 electron will pair in either of the 5 blocks. For sake of simplicity, we will show here the pairing is always in opposite direction. So this is for the 6th electron. If anybody shows, if anybody represents this as wrong configuration, if it is represented like this, not in opposite direction. Here one electron in upward, another in downward, and it is accurate pairing. P pairing is also here, but this is not taken as accurate pairing because both electrons are, both half ion are in upward direction. It is wrong. It is wrong and this is correct. On the basis of Hund's rule, we may also know about the magnetic behavior of the substance. If substance is slightly attracted towards magnet in magnetic field, it is known as paramagnetic. And if substance is not attracted by magnet but repelled by magnet, then that is known as diamagnetic. If all the orbitals in atom, in electronic configuration of the atom is full filled, that atom or that ion will be diamagnetic. And if either orbital out of all present in the required electronic configuration is incomplete, then clearly, that atom or that ion will behave as paramagnetic. Means that will be slightly attracted by magnet in magnetic field. Question. Check the paramagnetic and diamagnetic in following sodium, magnesium, phosphorus, argon. Answer: sodium 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. So this is full filled, this is full filled, this is full filled. The 3s orbital is incomplete. It will have unpaired electron. That is paramagnetic. Next, Mg, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. All orbitals are completely filled. Hence, it is diamagnetic. Phosphorus 15, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p3. थ्री पी ऑर्बिटल इज इनकम्प्लीट सो इट इज पैरामैग्नेटिक Now inert gas argon (1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6) All orbitals are fulfilled. Hence, it is diamagnetic. It will not attracted by magnet. Diamagnetic. Next question, how may we calculate the number of unpaired electrons for given atom or ion? Whatever the ion is, cation or anion, positive charge or negative charge? Question, find the number of unpaired electron in Cr chromium. Atomic number of chromium is 24. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d5, 4s1. Copper atomic number 29 and chromium atomic number 24 both avoid the above sequence because in case of chromium we will have 4 electrons in outermost shell. In case of copper we will have 9 electrons in outermost shell since full fill and half fill orbital is more stable then one less hence to make stability 3d will pull one electron from the its neighbor so above rule does not hold good in case of copper and chromium the electronic configuration of copper this d will have 5 electrons here 3d and 4s both are incomplete 3d and 4s both incomplete 3d of the 5 types वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव, फोर ईयर्स इज आफ्टर वन टाइम, तो फाइव इलेक्ट्रॉन इन डी, वी विल डिस्ट्रीब्यूट फाइव इलेक्ट्रॉन इन डी बाई होम रूल, वन बाई वन, फर्स्ट सेकेंड थर्ड फोर्थ फिफ्थ, पेयरिंग विल नॉट पॉसिबल बिकॉज इट विल हैव ओनली फाइव इलेक्ट्रॉन, यस ऑर्बिटल विल हैव वन इलेक्ट्रॉन, तो टोटल नंबर ऑफ अनपेयर्ड इज इक्वल टू फाइव ऑफ थ्री डी, वन ऑफ फोर, सिक्स।